What's up, guys? Jerry here. And if you don't know, Valve has just announced the Steam controller. And wow, is all I have to say. I was not expecting this at all. Like, I knew that they were going to release a controller, but the type of controller that they released, wow. Like, let's just say I never looked at any of the quote-unquote leaks that were coming out for this controller, so I had no idea what to expect at all. Like, I was thinking that this thing was going to be like a 360-esque controller with like a trackpad on it, I think I heard someone mention before. And like, so I'm in Steam, right? And I'm scrolling down, I'm like, okay, reading this stuff, cool. New way to play your entire Steam library from the sofa. Okay, cool, cool. And I'm scrolling down, got cats and dogs and shit. And I'm like, okay, I don't know what that's there for. And then I see this. What the fuck? What the fuck? What is this? Like, is this a DJ booth? Is it upside down? Like, what is this? I'm looking at it, I'm like, oh my god, this is gonna be fucking terrible. Like, I don't even know what to do with this. Like, I'm just looking at it. But then, I started reading through some of the features that this thing's gonna have, and basically, I'll just run them down and let you guys decide. So basically, the draw of this thing is that it's going to have dual trackpads. So there's no analog sticks like a 360 or a PS3 controller. So they've gotten rid of that. And they claim that the trackpads have a much higher resolution than a traditional analog controller, so it's going to be a lot more precise. Now, I know a lot of people that are keyboard and mouse gamers, they always complain about how the analog controller has no precision, it's sloppy, and according to Valve, this is going to close the gap, which, me being a former console gamer, I definitely welcome that, because I've tried playing with like first-person shooters with my controller, my 360 controller, and man, this shit's just not fair sometimes. Like, everyone's so fucking fast and precise, it's like ridiculous. So if this will allow me to be more competitive while playing with the controller, I'm definitely excited for that. So like, they also are going to have their own type of haptic feedback. So it's not going to be like your traditional like rumble pad or rumble stick that come in the 360 and PS3 or whatever controllers for however many generations now. So they claim that the improved the feedback on that is going to be much improved, which I think that's cool too. And they're gonna have a touchscreen on it, and the touchscreen, me personally, I think touchscreens are gimmicky. I don't really care for them. Like, what is gonna show on the touchscreen that you can't just show me on the screen itself? Like, why do I need to take my concentration off of the screen and look down at this controller for what? So, I don't know. I'm not sold on that part. Like, it's not gonna hinder me, but I just kinda think it's unnecessary. And my biggest concern though, if I actually scroll up here and take a look again, is the buttons, though. The X, the Y, and the A and the B. And the reason that they're concerned for me is the placement. Now, Valve claims that they've got this symmetrical placement. It's the most ergonomic It's got the best ergonomic comfort, and I just don't see it that way. Like, my problem mainly is with the X and the Y buttons. Like, let's say for instance, you're playing a racing game. Let's say you have your hand on the left trackpad, you're going through a turn, and the game requires you to press the X or the Y button while you're in the middle of that turn. Like, basically, you are either gonna have to take your left thumb off of the trackpad to press one of those buttons, you're gonna have to try to press both at the same time with your left thumb, or you're gonna have to reach way across the controller with your right thumb in order to press those buttons. So I don't understand the placement there. I think that the buttons should be on one side of the controller so that the other side you can use for direction, for precision type things. And I don't think that this is really gonna work. So I'm curious to see if they're gonna keep this button layout in the future, but I don't see how that's gonna work. Because the buttons are too close to the trackpads, and I don't understand how they expect you to press those buttons while also keeping your hands on the trackpads as well. So, like, if you scroll down here, though, and take a look, this is basically how the layout of the controller is going to be in comparison to your traditional keyboard and mouse layout. So, you've got like two shoulder buttons on the top of the controller. You've got two trigger buttons down at the bottom. You've got your two trackpads, your four buttons, a touch screen, and they didn't really mention what the three rectangular buttons do in the middle there, so I'm not sure what those are for. But basically, to me, this kind of looks like a modded 360 controller. Like, I'm sure like some of the professional console gamers, you've seen it, they have these aftermarket controllers where they've got extra buttons on them, like triggers on the bottom, so that they don't have to take their fingers off of important functions in order to do certain things. And I kind of think that this is where they've gone with it. They've basically taken like a professional gamer controller and they scrap the analog joystick controls and they put in trackpads that are supposed to be more precise. So like I'm thinking that this thing is gonna be better than what is offered for the PlayStation 4 and what is offered for the Xbox One. And if a PC controller can be better than what is out there for console, this is the type of shit that's gonna draw console gamers to PC. Like, if you can get this type of precision and controls from PC, then what do you need the console for? Because the PC is gonna have better graphics, it's gonna have better controls, and if it gets more people to switch over to it, maybe it'll get a little bit more of the gaming market, and we won't have to wait for shit to come out several months after it comes out on console, like GTA 5. Fuckers. But yeah, like I'm excited for the controller because I like gaming with the controller. Even if it's in a first-person shooter, I try to game with the keyboard or mouse. It is better. I still get my ass kicked, but the controller just feels more natural for me. Because I've been a console gamer since, let's see, I had an original Nintendo, I had an Atari 2600. I didn't get those new though, by the way, but probably the first new console that I got was the Sega Genesis. And I've been a console gamer ever since then. I just switched to PC a few months ago. So, like this type of shit, I know a lot of people don't a lot of the traditional PC gamers, they don't really care. Like, I'm just gonna keep my keyboard and mouse, and I don't need a TV for this shit. But for someone like me that is used to that, like, I love it. SteamOS, this controller, is gonna be badass. Now, one other thing though that does concern me just a little bit is the openness portion of this. So they want people to be able to contribute to the controller, and I don't know that I want players contributing to how this controller is going to work or the button layouts and things like that. Like, beyond just making keyboard layouts for games that normally don't support a controller, or I'm sorry, for making button layouts for games that don't traditionally support a controller, I don't mind them being involved in that. But as far as it being quote unquote hackable, I don't know, that kind of scares me a little bit. I don't know what's gonna come out of that, but I mean, overall, I'm pretty excited about this thing. I think this and the Steam OS are what is going to drive console gamers to the PC market. It'll provide a better overall gaming experience, and it'll make the transition better because when you're a console gamer, you don't want to just switch to a keyboard and mouse right away because it feels weird. You suck at it. It's a big transition. Just like PC gamers don't want to use a controller because it's a big transition. It's weird. So if you can release a controller that's going to be on the level of keyboard and mouse controls, or at least close, it bridges the gap. It gives people options to where they can game with whatever they want, but still be competitive. So that to me, that's a good thing. So I mean, basically that's it. I hope that I get to beta test one of these things. I did all the crap that they needed so I could be entered. I know I probably have like a 0.2% chance of actually getting to be able to, but if I do get to by some luck, then I definitely will make sure that I can post videos of that shit if I can. And, oh yeah, by the way, this small little picture here, this is what you'd be beta testing. So even though the controller, it's supposed to be wireless and it's supposed to have a touch screen on it, but the ones that get beta tested, they're just gonna send out, I guess it's gonna be wired, and it's gonna have these four buttons here that are gonna mimic the four sections of a touch screen. So it's not gonna be like the full finished thing that you get to test drive. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Let me know what you think about this controller and if it's something that you are gonna use. Let me know if you don't even give a fuck. If you're like, fuck controllers, fuck Steam OS, fuck the Steam machine. I have everything I need. Just release Half-Life 3 and shut the hell up. Let me know if you think that as well. And that's about it, guys. So, see ya.